What's up, people? This is Jimmy About It Hood, aka Eve Sweat. And in this episode, we're going to talk about this 5-ounce Buffalo Note Silver Bar. And also, a little bit of Bitcoin. Stay tuned. First and foremost, man, just want to say thank you to all the support on our channel, as well as our podcast and all of our platforms. But yo, do me a favor, please share this video, hit the like button, subscribe, do all the stuff that you're supposed to do, you know what I'm saying, when you're on YouTube, all that fly stuff. But listen, man, also special shout out to all the new students of By the Hood University, especially those that came through because of our Intro to Precious Metals course. It's been a tremendous success in terms of getting the community involved in precious metals. But that doesn't mean I'm going to stop bringing you the content on YouTube to talk about things that are added to the stack. And just, you know, what's going on in the world of precious metals. So, I got this bar right here, 5-ounce bar. It's like a 1901 banknote with a bison on it. You know what I mean? Special shout out to all my people from Howard University. I'm, you know, Howard adjacent because, you know, all my closest friends went to Howard. And I spent a lot of time on the campus. So, I'm Howard adjacent, but, you know, it's still HBCU. But I want the Lincoln. But that's either here nor there. Shout out to y'all, though. But this is a 5-ounce bar. You know, nothing really to it. Nothing special. But it gives you a way to get a quick 5 ounces of silver. And, you know, the last video we talked about rounds versus bars. But just wanted to show this bar, you know, in particular. It's a dope little bar. You know what I'm saying? Bison, you know, looking hard and whatnot. I got the Griseldas back there for no other reason than I just think it looks fly to do a video with Griseldas or Eagles in the back. So they there. Also got a little bit of gold there. That's about a 1/2 ounce of gold, 1/2 ounce of Eagles of gold. But another thing I want to talk about real fast is cryptocurrency. So why am I bringing up cryptocurrency on an episode of our content surrounding precious metals? Well, that's because the price of gold this morning dropped a little bit, and I saw multiple articles because Bitcoin is on the rise. And by the way, I do own Bitcoin as well, so shout out to Bitcoin. And yes, you can buy, like, you know, gold rounds that look like Bitcoin. Look at the detail. This is hard. But the reason I'm bringing up cryptocurrency and Bitcoin specifically is because a lot of the speculation is with the gold prices dropping that people are just moving into cryptocurrency as more of that safe haven asset. Because remember, one of the things I always talk about on this channel is that these precious metals are not just an investment, but also insurance, and probably more so insurance and investment, because you're locking in the value and you're protecting your money more so than you are trying to grow your money, right? So it's a protection mechanism. And a lot of the speculation is people are moving more towards cryptocurrency than they are metals. But what I find interesting about this is I'm someone who reads history, and in someone who reads history, there's always these new currencies. And people say, well, this currency will replace gold, or we no longer need gold or silver. But somehow, after thousands and thousands of years, precious metals still hold a place with people. It's like we're just like somehow connected to it in a way. And I'm not trying to get too deep on here. But it's like a different level of connection with humans versus precious metals. And I say that to say this, history shows me that they will always have value. They're desirable. They have utility. They're scarce and they're transferable. That's the little acronym DUST. The same thing that applies to real estate. It applies to precious metals. So it'll always have value. Now, I'm not an either or guy, right? In the words of the great philosopher and prophet named Cameron Giles, man, I do both. Who am I to mess tradition up? One of the things you'll notice on this channel, in terms of our content, is we don't argue back and forth about which asset is the best, because to me, that argument is ridiculous. Because, you know, you'll have your people that are, I'm a stock guy, or I'm a real estate guy, or I'm a metal guy, or I'm a crypto guy. You know, we've had people that are 100% crypto, and there's nothing wrong with that. If that's your thing, that's your thing. But I believe in diversification. And I do understand the power of cryptocurrency. It's very powerful. And I also understand the investments that's being made into the space to build that space out. And to be honest with you, some of the brightest people I know, they're working on the blockchain one way or another. Not even if it's not specifically with a particular coin, they're just in that space doing their work. So I understand that it is going to be the future. But with that being said, this isn't going anywhere. So I don't want anybody to panic and say, okay, I got to move everything over to crypto. Because, you know, listen, do both. Or don't do both. If it suits you to go over there, that's fine too. But I just wanted to give my perspective because I saw that multiple times today with people saying, oh man, I'm getting rid of all my metals and moving into crypto. I'm not. I'm buying more. In fact, the fact that, you know, precious metals price dropped, I actually bought some silver today. You know, I bought some silver. Of course, I bought Eagles, Buffaloes, and some OVOs, Canadian Maple Leafs. But it is what it is. That's what I always buy. 9 times out of 10, that's what I'm buying. And it's crazy, right? So anytime I order something different, so give you an example. This past Black Friday, I was on AppMex trying to get one of them door knocker deals. Couldn't get what I wanted. I had a gold coin, or gold round rather, in my cart. By the time their site finished crashing, I couldn't get it. But I ended up getting a discount on one of those John Wick silver rounds, which I wanted anyway. But I can't help it. Even when I ordered that round, I went ahead and ordered, like, you know, one Eagle. I ordered one Maple Leaf, and I ordered one Buffalo. So it's like, anytime I order, I'm ordering. So doesn't matter what order I put in, I'm always ordering those three. So I know off rip, I'm gonna spend $90 on every order at least before I even buy what I want. But you know, but those are my favorites, man. That's what I'm stacking, man. You know what I'm saying? And the great thing about precious metals is it doesn't take a lot to get started, but you get started, and once you have that sense of accomplishment, it can help you build out everything else. Once you understand and you can physically hold your asset in your hand, that's also a different level. Now, as I mentioned here before, I don't keep everything on person. And one of the things that I'm actually thinking about doing, and I know a lot of people in the metals community will call me crazy for this, but I'm going to drop some of them in a safety deposit box. So I use like a private storage, but I'm at the point now where I want to spread stuff out in multiple places. So I don't have, not only do I not have them in the house, but I don't even have them all in one place, say in like private storage. I want to put a little bit in safety deposit box, a little bit in private storage. You know what I'm saying? A little bit at a family member's house. So therefore, my stuff is spread out as long as I can track and know what I own. And that's another reason why I'm stacking more densely too. So you'll see me buying 10-ounce bars and probably more gold. But, you know, so those are my thoughts today. Just wanted to bring this quick video to talk about, you know, Bitcoin versus, you know, silver and gold. And, you know, shout out to the Eagles. Eagles always going to be here. But, you know, this is about a half ounce. It's about 5 here. I'm going to do a video on those too, because I did a video on a couple of them saying, you know, but I added a couple more to the stack since then. So it's about 5 here, which is about a half ounce, which is dope. Half ounce of gold. But, then you know, ounce. But, yeah, man. So this is the Bison here. This is 5 ounces of silver. And those are my thoughts on cryptocurrency versus metals. You know, but do what you must, though. If you're a guy that wants to go 100% into crypto, God bless you. I'm not into arguing these days, man. Everybody going to do what they want to do. And I'm going to do what I want to do, which is stack this bread one way and the other. Shout out to Ish, who always says that. Not one way, you know, or another. One way and the other. You know what I'm saying? I'm stacking my bread one way and the other. So with that being said, man, make sure that you, you know, support whatever we got going on. Take a look at our intro to Precious Metals course that we got. A lot of people in the community are now getting involved, and we're actually having conversations, which to me is the most amazing thing in our private group. It went from just options trading, stock investing, real estate. Now we got a whole metals conversation going on, which is completely fire. Yeah, but, you know, check us out. Go to bodyhooduniversity.com and see all the courses we got going on. And, you know, stay in tune. But I'll see y'all in the next episode. Peace.